We have loads of notebooks somewhere in the basement or something, which are notebooks full of Joseph's drawings. They weren't always closed, but a lot of them were closed. And they actually probably started maybe around 8 years old, 9 years old, 10, something like that, when you really got into the ballet thing.
My designing is very drawing based at the beginning. So I draw for like 5 to 6 weeks. And then you move into three-dimensional, you know, tailoring and draping, and you kind of go from there. And usually it does change when you start fitting. So when I started developing the collection, actually the first piece I designed was this one. So a lot of it had to do with how you dressed for the city and in the city. And so there was this idea of backpacks, of sport as well, that started to be developed through the process. I didn't go to fashion school, so I worked at Marc Jacobs and then Proenza, and then I worked for Givenchy, for Ricardo. Yeah. I think it's partly my personality. I like being entrepreneurial and having it be my own.
But you had a sort of schedule. You said, I need to learn these things. You know, I'm graduating from college. These are the things I need to learn in order to start my company. So there was never a moment when I think Joseph thought, I'm going to be working in a big company in an atelier. I think
not forever. No.
The intention was, I'm going to start my own brand.
But when we were working on this whole side of the collection, the idea of, I think, of nature was also really interesting, and the way that kind of the city is related to nature, or how they view nature. And so it came into play really when we started looking at Hawaiian shirts. I think there's been kind of an interesting renewal and as well as a kind of shift, generational shift in American fashion. When you're looking at the Paris market, the landscape of kind of the fashion scene here is mostly fashion companies that are owned by big conglomerates, which you don't necessarily have in companies in New York, because most of the companies are smaller and they're privately owned, and there is still this, you know, there's still this necessity to have to sell what you're showing. And then when we were working on the last section of the show, because we really do work in sections, the idea of incorporating the print within kind of more of a, I guess, more of a couture volume was really interesting to me. Mm-hmm. And a lot of it had to do with kind of these sports that were very aggressive, mm-hmm. but also where you needed a lot of protective gear. Mm-hmm. Well, I think she helps me, you know, the same way any kind of, you know, business support would ultimately. It so happens that she's my mother, but there is, you know, I think that I would say that the support itself is you know, it's a very,
very collaborative effort. I mean, we started basically the two of us together, except I was an intern.
I think the challenge is really finding pieces which women will want to wear, but that they'll be able to incorporate with the much lighter pieces in their wardrobe. Because we do, you know, I think what really interests me is designing things that women don't have in their wardrobe already.